field here today, including seven athletes who have previously broken 4 minutes for the mile.
Matt Giusto, there's Don Bowden right there. He starts it with Tom Moore, the official starter for the day, standing right behind him, and they're off in the mile run. They're going to turn this corner, run down the back straight into that freshening breeze off the Pacific Ocean. And the question was whether that breeze on the back stretch would slow them down to diminish their chances of running 4 minutes.
Well, that's where drafting comes into play. And as you can see, we've got a designated rabbit out here today, that being Mark Mastalier, a sub-4 minute miler himself, former Stanford athlete. And it's Mastalier with Mike Stone closely on his heels and Jim Sorensen in third place in the early going here.
And Giusto running back in the pack at this point. And I like Giusto because he went to San Mateo High School. That's where I went to school too, Mike. Had to throw that in, you don't mind.
Not at all. You'll notice at the back of the pack there is the Kenyan athlete. That's Wilson Wegwa, who's the American world record holder in the Masters Mile. And that's Matt Giusto moving up on the outside.
He really ran the first couple of laps in a very relaxed manner, very contained, was not in a hurry to get to the lead.
Well, the first lap split there was 60.9 seconds. They're behind pace. And remember, there's a $5,000 bonus here to be the first man to break 4 minutes for the mile in San Francisco. Never been done before.
Here's Matt making a contained move, if you will, on the back straight. Coming to the corner now at the west end of Kezar.
That's the 600-meter marker. Mark Mastalier is pulling them through nicely. In second is Jim Sorensen. Behind Sorensen, we've got Matt Giusto and Aaron Ramirez, who was an Olympian at 10,000 meters. Mastalier, Ernie Freer, Richie Boulay of Cal, Greg Whiteley.
And they're going to get it under 2 minutes at the split here, 159.9, not much under 2 minutes.
Well, they're going to have to really work this third lap here in order to break that four-minute barrier. Mark Mastalier, your rabbit, was scheduled to run the first 1,000 meters, which they're coming up on, and that's Greg Whiteley just ahead of Matt Giusto there. Matt Giusto coming around Greg Whiteley, and here's Aaron Ramirez close on his heels. They're really starting to turn it up down the back straight. That's a pretty heavy headwind there that they're fighting. And it's Matt Giusto. Matt Giusto with Aaron Ramirez in second, Whiteley third, and Sorensen fourth.
They really are picking up the pace here. And I was standing with Don Bowden at this point in the race, and Don was talking if the wind would subside a little bit in the back stretch, they would have an opportunity to get well under 4 minutes. And boy, was he right. You know what, Mike? The wind just went dead calm on that fourth lap.
It's Giusto at 2 minutes, 59.8 seconds. Whiteley in pursuit, and I believe that's Aaron Ramirez. Yes, Aaron Ramirez in third place there. Giusto and Whiteley coming out of the penultimate turn down the back straight. It's Giusto, and Whiteley's going to give him a race today.
And no one in San Francisco has ever run under 4 minutes. Don Bowden ran under 4 minutes in Stockton. Jim Ryan, of course, had his great run in 1966 at Edwards Stadium in Berkeley.
Under 200 meters remaining, and it's Matt Giusto with Greg Whiteley coming up on his right side, coming up on the outside. This is Greg Whiteley. It's going to be a dogfight coming up the final straightaway here. Look at the acceleration of Matt Giusto looking over his shoulder. I think he's going to do it. Yes.
Oh yes.
Yes. Oh, yes.
And he knows
it,
too.
He's got it. Last lap, I got in 55.8 seconds.
Wonderful. Wonderful performance. The crowd was really excited. And here's the interview.
Oh, it's fantastic. This means so much to me, to my family. I want to do this. I did it for my family, who's San Francisco natives. And it's meant so much to me to break 4 minutes, to be the first person to break 4 minutes in San Francisco, as well as being born in San Francisco. I couldn't explain to you how nervous I was before this race, but I knew my capabilities, and I predicted 354, 355, and as it turned out, it worked out fine for me.
Does this make up a little bit for last year's disappointment, the stress fracture at the Olympic trials? Now you seem to be back sharper than ever and ready for the Nationals coming up in a few weeks.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I feel fantastic right now. And last year was a setback, but hey, that's the way sport is, you know? You have your good days and you have your bad days, and you have to have the bad ones to have the good ones. Of course, it's a little bit of motivation for me this year, but I feel good, I feel strong, I'm focused, I'm ready to run.
Here are the final results now, Mike, as Giusto, 355.63 officially, and that makes him the leader in the world right now. Now to reflect on our Foot Locker athlete of the meet, Matt Giusto, winner of $5,000, courtesy of Pearl Azumi Technical Wear. For a sub-4-minute mile, 355.63. Freddie, what a performance.
The world outdoor leader this year. It's great to see Matt having such a good season after that injury at the Olympic trials that took him out of an Olympic possibility last year.
Mike Finelli did a great job, our meet director and our colleague here on this telecast, and there he is presenting the check. Other track and field meets coming up, Fred. This was a great one. We had a great one last week in Modesto, but there are more coming. Maybe we were born to run.